भाई तुक्का चलेगा ब्रो, गैस कर लू ना
भाई, आपने कितने तुक्के मारे।
Hi champs, welcome back to your own channel Knowledge Kuruji. So here we are with a super video on the most fatal mistakes which we commit in our written exam. I guarantee you that within the next few minutes, you will be equipped with all the cautions that you must exhibit in the examination hall. The mistakes which you will see will follow a step-up pattern ranging from the smallest mistakes to the biggest ones. Moreover, there are two big announcements for you at the last. So do watch the whole video. So, without any delay, let's come on to the first mistake, that is thinking too much. While solving a question, we think a lot of things. Like, if my answer would be correct, should I mark it? What if it gets wrong? What if I am using another formula? These all are your time-killing factors. Let me tell you that the examiner who has made the question paper has asked you to-the-point questions, but we generally think the opposite way. The next mistake is not following the directions on OMR. Now, this is the most blunder mistake which can create a major downfall. Suppose on the OMR, it's written that you have to mark answers with black pen and you solved the whole paper with blue. Now, your paper will not be accepted by the interpreter. So, here is a useful tip to you. Extract the previous year question papers and read those OMR instructions thoroughly before your exam. Now you will get an insight of what is demanded from you. Mistake number 3. Hurrying or panicking. We generally panic in the examination hall and here we commit a big mistake. That is hurrying. And then we solve the further questions but with ignoring the minute details of questions. Let me explain to you with an example. Suppose there is a question to find the word opposite in meaning and in hurrying to the next questions you did not read that. Here, most probably you will lose marks by choosing a word which is similar to the meaning. Another example, suppose there is a question which of these following statements is incorrect and again in hurrying towards next questions, you mark the answer which is correct. Another example, suppose you have options first as 3, second as 25, third as 2 and fourth as 0. And you got the answer as 2. Here, if you are in a hurry, most probably you will mark the second option, which is actually 25. So here also you will lose your marks. Why I am giving so much examples in that is only because we commit the most of our mistakes through this only. So don't hurry, don't panic, stay calm. Since I promised you all in my previous video to include a left out topic, so here we are with our next mistake. Marking the questions in an incorrect manner. See, there are two types of students. First, the students who solve all the questions on the question paper first and then collectively mark all the answers on the OMR at the last. Second is the students who first mark on their question paper and then on the OMR successively. Are you all getting the point, guys? Okay, we will learn it from an example. Suppose there are two students A and B. Both are attempting the same written exam. What A does is that he calculates the answers of questions, suppose 70 questions, and he marks all the answers on his question paper, leaving his OMR sheet blank till the last. And he is in a fact that he will mark all the answers collectively on the OMR at the last. What B does is that he calculates the answers, first tick the option in the question paper and then mark the answer on the OMR simultaneously. Now I hope you all got my point. Here let me tell you the most probable chances. One chance is that you can transfer an incorrect answer on the OMR by misplacement of the question's number. Second is that you will not be able to transfer all the answers on the OMR due to shortage of time at the last. So here is the most essential tip for you. Don't follow anyone from A and B. All you have to do is to mark the answer on the OMR at the same time you solve the question. It means that you will only mark the answer on the OMR, but your question paper will not contain any tick marks. Next mistake is ignoring the clock. I strongly recommend all of you to carry a wrist watch with you because at the examination time, your time management determines your marks. So keep a hawk's vision at the clock and solve the paper. Next big mistake that you often do while attempting the written exam is that you admit defeat and surrender. You admit that you have less time left in the paper. You admit that you will not be selected. You admit that you will not clear the cutoff. And all these things even before attempting the whole paper and giving your best. See, all these instructions unknowingly reach to your subconscious mind. And your subconscious mind is the site of your infinite intelligence. This is the most sensitive part and it accepts everything what approaches to it, whether it be true, false, good or bad. So always give your best without thinking of the outcomes. You will definitely get that what is written for you. And now the most asked question of all the students and the biggest mistake which is inbuilt in all of us. Negative marking or what we call tukka. Negative marking is a huge trap which takes you over and over and constantly eats your score. Look, you only see the positive side of it. You see that you will lose only 1/4 of the marks. But look at its original side. It says that while guessing, you will lose 25% of your score. There is only 25% chance of getting your guessed answer as correct. So please, please don't go for guessworks. Mark those answers which you genuinely know are correct. But if you have two options eliminated from the four options, you can go for a guesswork because now you have a 50-50 chance. And remember, use your brain and don't go for random guessing. Another place where you can go for guesswork is when you know your score and the cutoff. Suppose you calculated that your score is coming out to be 160 and the cutoff is 180. Here you must go for a guesswork. But remember, guess only those questions which according to you have a high probability to be correct. It's all in your hands, but according to me, you should leave those questions and should not go for random guessing if there is no urgency. I know sometimes it happens when we take the questions on our ego. Suppose you know that you are the master of arithmetic progression and you solved many questions related to it before. But at the examination hall, you are not able to solve it. So here all you have to do is to control your emotions and move on to the next question. And here, unknowingly, you learnt 8 big lessons. Yes, it's true. But hearing is not enough. I strongly recommend you to prevent yourself from committing such mistakes and my most repeated advice. Practice yourself and then see the change in you. You might have heard the famous quote of Muhammad Ali, the greatest boxer of all times. He says he hated every moment of his training, each and every moment. But he thought, suffer now and live the rest of your life as a champion. With this, we end up with the most fatal mistakes which we do while solving any written exam. Do comment the mistakes which you do while attempting the sample papers. Because if you write it today, you will have a positive mindset on the exam day. Moreover, I will suggest my personalized remedies for such mistakes to your comments. Now let's come on to those important announcements. First is that hopefully we will soon be conducting our first Q&A session in the next week. So ask as many questions in the comment section till you don't get satisfied. And we will pick the best question and convey to our audience the most brilliant answer. Second is, you all know that you are nearly 2 weeks away from the written exam. So if you haven't practiced well, do buy this book. The link is in the description where you will get it at an extra discount as this book will satisfy all your needs. Okay guys, goodbye. Till then, stay happy, stay healthy, stay tuned and practice to your fire level. Paper fold ke aana hai.